Hi, Brent Tree here, president of Unifor Local 88. Just want to give you an update on what's happened since we last had a video. Auto Council met in London on April 20th, which brings together the Detroit 3 plants to discuss auto-related issues. Lots of discussion was around the transition to electrification and effects it will have on jobs, both in the assembly plants and the parts supplier plants in the area. Most plants are still struggling to get the semiconductors, along with many other parts, to keep their plants running on a regular basis. During this auto council, a new auto policy was developed, and Unifor Auto Policy Working Group with four main core pillars. Number one, growing the domestic industry. Number two, managing the transition to net zero. Enhancing the skills needed to succeed. Creating high-quality union jobs. Advancing equality and inclusion. It was agreed by all that all levels of government need to be involved in the transition to electrification so Canada does not miss out on product allocation from the Detroit 3. Just a few reminders going forward into this week and into our layoff. When attending Pell on layoff, your employer will be Unifor National. The address is 115 Gordon Baker Road, Toronto, Ontario, area code M2H. 0A8, and their phone number is 1-416-718-8425, and you'll report 40 hours worked and they are going to be your employer. On this Friday, April 29th, the fundraiser for a family from Ukraine will be from 1 p.m. to 1 a.m. and the silent auction will continue online until midnight Friday. The auction items will also be on display at the hall for viewing, and bidding will all be accepted until midnight Friday as well. Due to the recent retirement of President Jerry Diaz, the position of National President is now vacant. Unifor Local 88 has endorsed Lana Payne as a candidate for National President of Unifor. The following, a motion was tabled at the April 19, 2022 Executive Board meeting of Unifor Local 88 and supported and passed. The motion was to endorse Lana Payne as candidate for the National President of Unifor. The recommendation was then tabled at the general membership meeting of Unifor Local 88 on April 24, 2022. That recommendation was supported and passed by the membership. And just on closing, during the upcoming layoff, please take care of your families and yourselves. Reach out to co-workers and friends from time to time just to say hello. If you are struggling with anything, do not do it alone. The Union Hall office and hall will be open during the layoff. Please call the following numbers if you require assistance with hall-related issues or any other issues, and we will pass it on to anybody in leadership that is working. You can call Linda Layton at 519-425-0952, extension 102, or on her cell at 519-636-2415 for anything relating to the office and the hall. You can call myself, Brent Tree, at 519-425-0952, extension 101. That's the office, or 519-317-6059, my cell. And if I can't answer your question, I will find somebody in benefits or somebody else on our implant that will be able to help us and get the issues resolved. Because of all the work being done in the plant, the benefit reps and some of the full-time reps in the plant and the chair will be working out of our office for the majority of the summer. So please call or drop by if you have any issues. Thanks and have a safe time off.
Hi, for the ones that don't know me, I'm Jeff Banks, the Local 88 Benefits Representative. We still get this question a lot. We have all our benefits for the duration of the layoff except for dental and S&A. Dental and S&A benefits for the most of the members will end at the end of May 31st. If you need glasses, physiotherapy, massage, all that other benefit stuff, you still have that. If there's any doubt, just give one of the three of us a call. If you are on S&A and you are recovering, you must clear the health center at that time. Do not wait until we all get recalled back to work. You will not get paid for anything. They will flip you over to layoff status if you are going to be on layoff still. Please contact the health center. They are in the plant the whole time. So as soon as you find out you're ready to go, you can go and contact the health center, contact one of the three benefits reps, and we'll walk you through the steps. If you're planning on traveling over the holidays and you're on EI, you must contact us or EI to let the Service Canada know that you are leaving the country or traveling because you're not ready and willing and capable of working. If you're on vacation, you can do it, but you still have to notify Service Canada.
Hi, I'm Stefan Cronin. I'm also one of the Unifor benefit reps here. I'm going to talk about the process when we come to the layoff, what to do with your EI. So if you have an EI claim right now in your current reporting, that's great. Keep doing that. You're not going to miss a beat. So when we get to the layoff week, you're going to report that you were laid off that week, that you're ready, willing, and able. The next week, you'll end up with a payment and your subpayment. It'll be great that way. You're going to keep doing that until you get to the weeks, amount of weeks that you were given by Service Canada, or you get to the 52-week period, then your claim's going to end. What you're going to need to do is when the claim ends, you're going to have to reapply, but I would wait to reapply until your last payment has been cleared. What they're going to do is they're going to take a look back the last 52 weeks when you start the new one, and the hours that you just work are going to give you more EI weeks. You'll be able to tell when you're getting close to the end of your claim because your report's actually going to tell you this is your last report, and that's how you go forward. For anybody that's got an EI claim and hasn't been reporting or stated that you started a full-time job, what you'll have to do is you're going to have to do a brand new application, but it's going to reactivate it when you get about halfway through. It's going to give you what you had eligible for weeks prior or until you get to the 52-week period, the same as the other one, and it's going to let you know when you get to the end of it, and then you'll just reapply for benefits again once that last payment gets cleared. For anybody that's starting a brand new claim this time around, so you haven't been reporting and you didn't have weeks prior, you're going to start brand new again. You're going to have a waiting period right off the bat, and you'll just have to apply. What we recommend for people, if you are reactivating your claim the last day of work, you can reactivate. If you're starting a new claim, we suggest people wait till either the Thursday or Friday after the start of the layoffs, the week after. That gives payroll time on Wednesday to put your ROE in before you apply. So that way, when you apply, the ROE is in, and sometimes the system will just automate your claim, and you won't have to have a Service Canada agent pick it up and complete it. The other thing we wanted to talk about was, please be aware that during the layoff, on page 3 of Rights and Responsibilities, it states that you need to be looking for active work. So there is a requirement that you actually have to be out there doing job searches. We realize that it's a temporary layoff and it's going to be extremely difficult for people to find jobs, but Service Canada reserves the right to call you in for a job search, interview, or audit. I would recommend people check out the EI guide that we put online. In there, it kind of outlines some of the requirements for the job search and kind of what they're looking for. So if anybody does get called in, they kind of know what to expect. If they call you in and you have nothing, you could end up being disentitled for that period. That's where you would owe back the EI and the sub. So it is pretty important. Just want to stress that.
Hi, everyone. Rob Galacci, Unifor Benefits Rep. If you're going on a maternity or parental leave during the layoff, please reach out to one of us benefits reps and we'll help you guide you through the process, switching over from layoff status to maternity or parental status. We've had some questions about school during the layoff. If you're collecting EI benefits, it is best to contact Service Canada. This way, you can inquire about the eligibility. It's up to Service Canada and their decision on schooling or any courses you might want to take during layoff. What to do when your EI runs out. If you have sub weeks remaining and you run out of EI, please contact us in the benefits office. There is a little bit of a process that we have to go through. If, depending on your sub eligibility, you'll qualify for full sub depending on 65% or 50% depending on where you fall. You should receive it on your pay stub. It will tell you the weeks of sub remaining. So please refer to your pay stub if you're uncertain of what weeks you have remaining. We'll need you to reapply for EI and get denied. With the denial letter, please get it to us in the benefits office, and we'll get that denial letter to Service Canada. This way we can get these subpayments started. If you've been here for 6 years at the start of the layoff and run out of both EI and sub, you'll qualify for IMP benefits. IMP covers you at 60% of your weekly wages, anywhere from 32 weeks to 52 weeks, depending on the years of seniority you've been here. There is a form you will need to fill out, so please contact us in the benefits office and we can email you that form. And we will submit that to the Canadian sub office. In closing, I'd like to thank everyone. Stay safe during this layoff. And from the benefits reps, Jeff, Stefan, and myself, reach out to us if you have any questions at all during the layoff. We're here to help you. Thank you.
Hello and welcome to another one of our videos. My part of this video will mostly be on postings, vacation, education leaves, and the contract books. I'll start with postings. We are going to start the posting process on May 16th. The plan is to bring 40 people per day by seniority, and we should have that calendar out later this week, so everyone will have lots of time to see when their pick date is to be done at the Union Hall. Officially, the pick times will be daily from 9 a.m. to 11 a.m., and again, we ask if you're the most senior people on that particular day to please come by 9 o'clock to keep the process moving. We have made some very good progress on this. The plan is now to regularly update using social media sites such as the CAMI website that shows postings, the CAMI Facebook, and our own Local 88 website. Hopefully a couple of times every week we're going to post all the jobs that have been taken so everyone can see what remains as they come. That way, as your day gets closer, you'll be able to have your choices more clear. We ask that after you pick your job, please double check on the social media site the next day or within the next couple days and confirm that the job we post for you is the job that you picked. We just want to make sure it matches and try and eliminate any mistakes that may happen. These jobs are for everyone. If you're on maternity, SNA, WSIB, education leave, you still need to pick by your seniority date. The only people that do not need to pick a job are those that have filled out the forms with ER who have the intention to retire or to quit. If you cannot make it for your pick date, you may have COVID, you may be out of the country on vacation, etc., you need to contact Tyler Veer of ER ahead of time. His contact info will be on our website and will also be on this video later. Do not wait till the last moment or that morning. Contact Tyler and make sure we get you fixed up. There are some people who still may not be decided if they want to retire or not when they're watching this video on Wednesday. Here is your issue. If you think you're going to post to a job and then walk into the plant and retire, you're going to come back to work prior to your 35 weeks. The way the whole calendar lines up, almost everybody will be back to work before your 35 weeks is up. Therefore, you're going to take yourself out of the ESA. If you're not sure where your timelines end up, if you're undecided right now, please contact Mike Murphy or myself prior to Friday. Okay, the next topic is vacation, and we have a huge update on vacation. We are going to bring everybody back to the Union Hall. Even if you're grandfathered, you must report to the Union Hall. Everybody, when they pick their job, are also going to pick their round one vacation on the same day. So we will have a calendar of every department by shift, and you'll have to pick your vacation right after you pick your job. So even if you're getting grandfathered, just to be clear, you still need to come in on the day of your seniority and pick either your job, your vacation, or both. So as I said earlier, we hope to have a calendar up later this week showing everybody's seniority date on a calendar. It'll start May 16th and should be done by the last week of June. So everybody will have to come in here. Again, if you cannot make it on your date for vacation or postings, please contact Tyler Veer and his information will be up on this video as well as our website. Education leaves. There has been a major change in the education leaves. If anyone wants to go to school for the upcoming fall term, you do not need to fill out an education LOA. The company is going to flip you to an unpaid LOA in September if you do this. You can remain on layoff status. The worst case scenario is in December. When you're recalled, you'll either work 1 or 2 weeks because we're doing a rotating layoffs. We'll get you to use your vacation, or we'll talk to the company about putting you on leave in because it's only for 1 or 2 weeks. Then we can talk to you in the fall about January to May and what it entails to get an education leave. Please contact myself or Mike Murphy if you're looking at an education leave from January to May. Contracts. We are getting asked where our new contract books are. This is our normal contract. Paragraph 38 is entitled Benefits. It's not real big. It's only half a page on this, but it refers to this book, which is our benefit book. Together, they form our entire contract. We cannot proceed and print these off unless this is completely done. There are some major issues going back to Big Three bargaining that we pattern language over that have taken a very long time to resolve. They are almost done. The Big Three bargained about 4 to 5 months before us. They still do not have their books to the printers. These issues are pretty much resolved right now. We hope to have our contract posted online in May, so everyone can actually start reading it or referring to it. And then hopefully we'll have the order in May as well for the books to be printed, and they'll be back sometime this summer. It has been unprecedented how long it has taken these books to go, but there has been some major language issues with benefits. And just finally to wrap up, there are thousands of Equinoxes parked all around the plant. The company is saying they're having a hard time getting trains to ship them. A couple of months ago, we asked the company to give everyone in the plant a free Equinox for building over 3 million of them with some of the top quality scores that they've ever seen. They haven't exactly said yes yet, but maybe it's just a coincidence. We would like to think everyone might get a free Equinox on the way home on Friday. They gave everybody a free travel mug yesterday at the celebration, so maybe they're going to give you a truck to put it in as well. Anyhow, during the downtime, please be safe. We are going to be down for a long time. I hope you guys take the time to reach out to friends and to coworkers and to make sure everyone's doing okay. Enjoy the summer. At some point, this country will finally warm up, and before you know it, and all too quickly, the leaves will change and our lines will start back up, but we will then start producing the best quality vehicles in the GM lineup that we are known for. Take care, everyone.